I will now explain bada's I/O and system namespace. First, let's have a look at the I/O namespace, and then the system namespace. After that, I will introduce the debugging macros, which are useful when developing applications. The I/O namespace provides functions to input and output data that is saved as types, such as files, directories, registries, and databases. First, let's briefly look at the bada file system. The directory that can be used in bada is a virtual path managed by the system and platform. In the path, directories are delimited by a slash. The maximum number of files that a bada application can open is 100, and the maximum number of directories is 30. The current application directory, meaning the working directory where the current application is running, is not supported. The bada file system is case sensitive. Now I will explain bada's virtual path. First, there are the home directories in the bada's virtual path. The home directories are /home and /home/share. Applications can read and write to the home directories. Additionally, there is a folder where the application's resources are collected. The files in the project's res group are saved in the res folder. Since this folder is the place where the resources are saved, you cannot write to the folder. The share folder is used to share data with other applications. There are two share folders. The first starts with /share/app ID, and the second starts with /share/app control/app control name. These folders are also read-only. Besides these, there are media folders to save images, videos, and files to. The media folders are the /media folder and the /storage card/media folder. These folders are also read-only. To save data in these folders, you can use the classes in the OSP media or OSP content namespace. This example acquires the file and directory names in a directory by using the directory class. Let's see how we can use the directory class. Specify the directory name, construct the directory, and get the enumerator using the readN function of the directory. The getCurrent, D-I-R-E-N-T-R, function of the enumerator returns the directory entry. The directory entry contains various types of file and directory information. This example shows how to manipulate directories and files by using the static functions in the directory and file classes. To create a new directory, you can use the create function provided by the directory class. By passing the directory path to the create function, you can create a new directory. You can also rename a directory using the rename function of the directory class. You can delete a directory using the remove function. Besides these functions, the static functions of the file class, such as the copy, move, remove, and get file extension functions are provided. This example reads and writes data to a file using the file class. First, when constructing the file, we specify the absolute path to the file. Here, the absolute path is the virtual path provided by the system. After opening a file, you can read or write data to the file using the read and write functions. At this time, you can use the character array, string, or byte buffer as the buffer to get data. In addition, a seek function is provided. So that you can move the pointer to any position in the file, like with the fseek function. The file class provides the tell function that returns the current position of the pointer. The additional functions provided by the file class are for getting the attributes of a file, such as get date time, get file size, get last modified time, is directory, is hidden, is normal file, is read-only, and is system file. Now, let's have a look at the database. The database is thread safe by using a mutex and supports the SQL subset, bada compatible SQL. You can use the bada database as follows. Construct the database with the database name and execute a SQL command to create a table. Then, create a SQL statement, bind the data necessary for the state, and execute the SQL statement to add a new entry to the database table. Let's see how we can use the database through an example. First, you have to create a database. Construct the database class with the database name. Then you can get the database. At this time, since there is no table, you have to execute the SQL command to create a new table. The table has an integer value in column 0, a double value in column 1, and a text string in column 2. So let's take a look at an example to add a row to this table. First, to get the mutex of the database, you have to execute the begin transaction command for the database, and then construct the statement to insert a data row. Bind the data to this statement and execute the statement. Then the database is ready for the row insertion. Finally, you can complete the transaction using the commit transaction function. This example shows us how to update the database contents. To update the data, start the transaction and execute the SQL command to update the data To update the data, start the transaction and execute the SQL command to update the data in the table. This example deletes a row. A SQL command to delete a row from the table has been executed. You can also delete the entire database. This example searches for a specific row in the database. Construct the database giving the database name and create the statement to search for data. Bind the keyword string to be searched for and execute the statement. Then you get an enumerator. You can get the number of found columns by calling the getColumnCount function of the enumerator and get the data using the getStringAt function. Next, I'll explain the registry. The registry is generally used to save application settings. The registry file provided by bada consists of sections. In each section, name value pairs can be inserted. The supported value types are integer, double, float, string, UUID, and byte buffer. Let me show you how to use the registry. First, to use the registry, you have to specify the reg name to a string variable. The reg name is /home/regtest.ini. Section 1 has been set as the section name, and S1 key 1 has been set as the key name. Then, construct the registry giving the registry name. Then you can read the registry. After that, you can add a section with a desired name to the registry by using the addSection function of registry. To add a key value pair to a section of the registry, call the addValue function, giving the section name, the key name, and the value. To read the added value, call the getValue function that returns the iVal containing the value.